don't know. Frisco, hi. You're just the man we wanted to see.
Yeah? Well, it's always nice to walk into a room and feel needed. What's up?
Well, we're trying to convince Terry to come to the policeman's ball with us tonight.
See, I don't think it's going to be right, you know, after Kevin's... You know what I mean?
Well, this isn't just a charity event, you know. It's a tribute to Anna.
Yeah, I owe her a lot.
Let's face it, we all owe her a lot. We gave her a pretty hard time.
Yeah, but don't you think it'd be strange, though, if I went?
No. Particularly because Anna Devane's being honored.
Yeah.
There's another reason why I think you ought to go, Terry.
What?
You've got to come back to the real world. It's part of getting into life again. We can't put it off forever.
He's right.
Patrick, are you going?
Yeah. I've said some rotten things about the Port Charles Police Department. I think I'd like to make amends. I think Anna would really appreciate it if you were there, too.
I'm going to have what my wife's having, which is soda with a twist.
You don't have to drink the same thing as me.
Why, are you on call tonight?
Well, I could be, but anyway, dancing with my wife all evening is the strongest wine I could have.
Wait to get to the ball because I plan to dance with you all evening.
Well, that's good because I have no intention of letting anyone cut in.
What is this about nobody cutting in?
Well, it's rough dancing with a stunning redhead like this. You never get a full dance.
You have experience with many other redheads.
Well,
no, don't say that. Don't say that.
All I know is I plan on dancing the entire evening.
Oh, you do?
Mm-hmm. Who knows when I'll get to dance again? I mean, the next couple of months, I'm going to have to put my dancing shoes away.
Tanya, when's the baby due?
The baby is due in early fall.
You know, as co-owner of the Brownstone, I kind of feel as if it's our baby, too.
You remember that when this kid wants to be fed at 2 a.m.?
Oh, my goodness, what did I get myself into?
It just means that we'll love you all the more.
Ah, here they come.
Is this not the most beautiful creature you have ever seen in your life?
Huh? It is.
You just wait till she comes down the aisle in a wedding dress.
I can't wait for that night.
I know, bachelorhood will be over for you.
You know, what about a bar?
Hey, a bar!
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Small bar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Make some drinks.
Okay.
What do you want?
Well, I don't care. Anything else. Get me there.
Am I dressed up enough? I don't want to be overdressed or anything.
You
even...
look perfect.
You look beautiful. Have a party. It's
going to
be a good time.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, I'll take you.
You know, I think there's something in the air tonight.
I can feel it. Can you?
Oh, yes, it's a good feeling.
I think it's also because the Brownstone family has finally gotten back together.
Long
time.
Yeah, yep. Well,
here's
Cheers.
The Brownstone.
Nothing is ever going to break up our family again.
Oh, I almost forgot. Frisco, did you tell him the good news?
What news?
Frisco finished his last academy assignment, which means there is nothing that can stand in the way.
Oh,
great.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Could I have a cocktail there?
What?
That'll be the phone.
Ooh, very good. Thank you.
Hello?
Hello, Bobby. By any chance, is Tony still there?
Hold on a minute. Tony, it's for you. It's Yank. He's at the hospital.
Yank? With Buzz. He's spiking a fever and his CBC shows a higher white count. I thought you should know. Okay, I'll be right there. Buzz is in trouble. His fever's up. He's got a high white count. Listen, I'm going to be back at the ball as soon as I can. If I can, just don't ruin Anna's evening telling her about Buzz, okay?
I haven't had time to congratulate the newlyweds. May you have all the happiness you deserve.
Oh, thank you, Ruby. I'm very
congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. How are the hors d'oeuvres?
Oh, I think they're perfect because I didn't have to make them.
Are you looking after Lila?
Oh, of course.
Not only that, Lila and Stella are looking after Ruby in the business. And I'm looking forward to some of that relish you all been talking about, Meg.
Oh, I just love Kim. So lively.
Mother's a very brave woman.
But we see you.
Okay.
Alan, what are you fidgeting for here?
Not fidgeting. I'm looking to see if Sean and Monica show up. If they do, it's going to be a big mistake. There are plenty of people here who'll be witnesses.
Have you ever tasted anything as good as these hors d'oeuvres?
Yes, your corned beef.
Let's get this right.
Come on, Claudia. At least you can smile.
I can give you hysterical laughter.
Hi, you two.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Hi.
How are you?
Hi.
What to drink?
White wine.
Two white wines, please.
Having fun? Fun? What's that?
Come on, this is a party.
What's that?
Derek, honey, what are we going to do with these two?
Well, I suppose a little good news won't hurt. Business is great in the spa.
Well, I don't care about business anymore. Now the only thing in my life is Derek. And, of course, the son. Look who's here.
Oh, thank you very much. Well. Hi. How you doing?
Somebody help me.
Oh,
the back.
Oh. It's not this. It's that.
There are two things in life I can't swallow, and they're both over there.
Good evening, everyone. Two white wines, vodka on the rocks, please.
I must be the only person who hasn't congratulated the newlyweds. Congratulations.
Oh, yes, my best of both.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Yes, thank you so much.
Big night for you, Anna.
Yes, I'm really nervous. Really, you're surrounded by all your friends, so don't worry.
And you have lots of them now.
Oh, even the mirrors.
Oh, hello. My smart. I should use it more often.
Let's talk to you for a minute, Monica.
What? I think he's very glad.
You think Sean's fooling me by walking in here with you and Anna?
Do you think you could manage not to be quite such a bore this evening?
You don't really think he's pulling the wool over my eyes, do you?
I see you cannot manage that.
No, Monica.
Evening.
You think so?
I don't want to seem
to you for a I was just telling Monica that...
I would rather not hear it again, Alan.
Shall we?
I'd love to.
Do you think we could manage a dance?
Academy right now. This whole policeman's ball, you know, it's like I'm part of it.
I'm so proud of you.
Are you really?
Yeah. I mean, getting to the police academy is something.
It wasn't anything, really.
No, Frisco. I happen to know that discipline is not one of your strong points.
Yeah? Well, wait till I get my badge. You know, you're something, too. Did I tell you that?
No, you didn't.
Asking Sam to be one of your bridesmaids. That was nice. Very nice.
Well, I thought she'd like to have a chance to wear a dress for a change.
She's wearing a dress right now.
And she looks forward into it. She has got a great figure. Oh, that poor girl.
What do you mean, poor girl?
Well, she's going to have to flatten out if she's going to wear a badge. Otherwise, who's going to be able to read the badge?
Oh. Very funny.
I thought you'd think it was funny.
Be nice. Here they come. Hi.
Felicia.
Oh, you look great.
Hi, Frisco.
Hi.
Isn't this great?
Yeah. How are you, Eric?
Fine, great.
Can you believe Sergeant Lewis giving us free tickets tonight? Isn't it wonderful?
What a guy. Yeah.
That's because you and Frisco are heroes for capturing that man. I think that what you and Frisco did on the waterfront was really something.
Heroes again. You want to dance, honey? Let's dance, Joey.
No, sweetheart. No, we can't dance. You might bump into somebody, and then you'd hurt your arm. And then you couldn't...
You guys dance, okay? Come on, let's get a drink.
You just couldn't get married. That would
yes, okay. We're not going to dance, all right?
Hey, you having a good time, Red?
I am having a wonderful time, my dear.
You know, you're turning into a fabulous dancer.
Really? Well, I have a very good instructor.
I like the touch.
Yeah.
Shoes are great.
pair of shoes.
I actually own a pair of these shoes. What?
I don't know whether you should ask Terry to dance or not.
I think maybe we'll just give her a few more minutes.
The mayor spoke to her. That was nice.
I think just the fact that she's here is something.
Excuse me, Mr. Mayor. I was wondering, when you were district attorney, didn't you almost put Sean Donnelly behind bars?
Yes, but it took a governor's pardon to stop me.
So I guess he still has to watch his step.
As far as I'm concerned.
How are you two doing?
Oh, we're hanging in there.
Yes, good. Yeah,
people have been very nice to us.
Good. Yes, they have. Just had a few bad moments.
Do you stand for little advice? When I was in the WSB, I went through some pretty harrowing experiences, but I really learned you just have to live life every moment. If you don't, you just dry up inside.
Does that suggest to you that we should dance at least once?
Does it? You bet.
Yes.
Yes, it does. Go ahead and have some fun. Yeah. Go on.
All right.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
I'd like to give you this.
What is this? My goodness, it's Heather.
Is that what it is?
Yes. You gave this to me.
The gentleman wouldn't give me his name, but he did say they're for you.
Thank you. Anna, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
What are these? Oh, what are these, special flowers?
Yes, it's a sprig of heather. It really reminds me of when I was a child.
Oh, well, who gave it to you?
I don't know his name, but he's right over there. It's gone.
Well, did you meet him here tonight?
No, I haven't met him.
He didn't say anything when he gave you the flowers?
No, that's a funny thing. You see, he sent a waiter over here, and it was all wrapped up, and, and earlier on, I dropped my scarf, and he stopped for me,
and now he's gone. He's not here at all?
I didn't see him anywhere, no.
That's kind of intriguing.
Yes, it is. How's Tony?
Well, he's fine. He stopped off at the hospital on the way over to check up on Buzz.
Send him my love.
I will.
It's good to see you.
I take those back to the kitchen.
Very romantic music.
The mayor.
May I have the pleasure of this dance, Mr. Mayor?
I used to gather it when I was a little girl.
You're a long way from home.
Yes. Judging by your accent, so are you.
And you're looking for a new home.
I've found mine. What about you?
Perhaps. Perhaps tonight I have.
Oh no, how could they do that?
Stay right here. I'll be right back with the drink.
I
Anna?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't mean to startle you.
No, it's all right.
You seem far away.
I was gathering heather.
I didn't know it grew around here.
You'd be surprised.
You know, it's almost time for the awards presentation, and I have been looking forward to that all evening. Are you ready?
Yes, as ready as I'm ever going to be.
Let's go.
I really have to say a speech.
Have you two been?
Good? Great.
Playing with your natural voice.
No, that's okay.
Your champagne will be waiting for you.
Applause is for Anna DeVay, who stands here beside me. All right, all right. That tells me to keep my remarks at a minimum. And Ms. DeVay has also asked me to keep my compliments at a minimum, too. Anna, Port Charles owes you a great deal. And this simple plaque is but a small token of our respect and appreciation for a job well done.
District Attorney for being here. I'm really very grateful for this sign that Port Charles has accepted me. I share this with a great many people who have helped me. The police, of which I am a proud member, always need your help and your cooperation. Crime breeds suffering. And we must all work together to relieve that suffering as much as possible. We should all live together as friends also. And sometimes those friendships are severely tested. But we all have the ability to forgive and to love again. And this has been clearly demonstrated by my friends here tonight. I'm very grateful and very touched. Thank you very much.
Something's going on, they need you over there right away.
You tell Sean and Monica that I've left. And you stay until the party.
Sorry, I heard you at the hospital, whatever.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to have to operate on Buzz tomorrow unless that infection starts to clear up.
Look, I can assist. I have a free day.
Good, that's what I wanted to know.
I'll be there.
Well, Tony.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Lou. I'm so glad you made it. How's Buzz doing?
Well, I was just telling Rick. Looks like we're going to have to operate on him tomorrow, and I just don't know whether it's still Anna or not. Yeah, well, she's not here. She was called to the station on an emergency. Come on, honey. You know, the night's very young yet. We don't have to end it.
I'll dream about it.
Well, dreaming is fine. I love to dream.
Frisco.
No. Honey, you know where I'm headed, don't
you?
Yeah,
I think so.
Well, then why don't you come upstairs with me to our own apartment? Okay, baby? Please.
happens.
Have you forgotten our little agreement since after the wedding?
Oh, no. No, I haven't forgotten our agreement that's driving me out of my mind.
Why is your sense of romance?
Well, honey, you can be romantic and happy at the same time, baby. I really need you.
And I need you, but, but, I mean, I don't want to risk hurting your elbow again.
My elbow? Now, come on, you're using that as an excuse to not make love with me.
Where is your romance? Where is your soul? Really, I think you're getting really.
Oh, we didn't run off, just came home a little early.
Well,
a little
excuse me, but I have to call it a night. I'm gonna go to my own.
Oh, well, honey, come on.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Good night. Good night. Good night.
Hey,
good night.
Hey, good night. I haven't seen my velvet paintings yet.
Good night.
I got them on Lafayette Street, New York.
Night. Tanya.
You got one on the line.
Where's Tony?
He's back at the hospital with Buzz. He took Rick along with him. Buzz is doing a lot worse.